Man, this is live. Anything can happen. Man, this is live. Anything can happen. Man, this is live. Anything can happen. Man, this is live. Anything can happen.
And what if you fuck up?
Man, this is live. Anything can happen.
I'd be pissed scared I'd get a boner or fucking fart or something.
Man, this is live. Anything can happen.
Shut the fuck up, man. You're making me nervous.
Me, the Junkman, coming back at you with another video, a live stream, the action figure show, a little different than the talk show format, and we're going to be a little light today because I had a lot going on, so you didn't get the pop culture show, you didn't get a normal video, and because of that, I didn't prep a lot for this show because I almost canceled it because I thought I'd be back by 7 to get this, and I got back about 6:45, so I was a little late getting back, so I didn't really prep the news, not really much news out there anyway. Got a little bit of news, but what we're going to do is we're going to watch 80s toy commercials and 70s commercials. And I'm going to put them up in the box in the little corner. Hopefully, I won't get demonetized or cut off or anything. I'm not sure if I'm going to have sound because that might knock me off. But I think we can still enjoy watching the commercials without the sound and everything. So I think that'd be pretty cool. I don't have my soundboard up, but I do have the video chat, because if you send a super chat, you will get a video clip, and we already got a super chat already. What's happening, Junkman Robert? Thank you so much for the support. It really means a lot, and it goes a long way, so thank you so much. We got 23 people in here. Stupid me, I put this video coming up on Unlisted. So, you know, I like to do it like 30 minutes or an hour before. That way you guys know it's about to come up. If you're not on social media or Twitter, you might miss it. So that's the best. If you any social media, this Junkman group or on Twitter, or I don't use Instagram as much. It's that Junkman is on Twitter now. So we throw that up there, you know, so you can find the link. But what was I saying? I lost my train of thought there. I put it up on here, so you know you get an alert also, and I put it on private. And I was like, why ain't it showing up? Why ain't it showing up? And then like 1 minute before we got started, I noticed. I said, hey, that's why. Robert sends in a super chat. He gets himself a super chat video, a random video for sending a super chat. Here you go, Robert. This one's just for Robert. The other guys, please, everybody else, please close your eyes. There we go. Something else we're going to start doing. Not today. I don't know if it's going to be on the action figure show. It's probably going to be during a Friday show where we kind of do a free form where Friday's not really a topic. Not sure yet if it's going to be bi-weekly on Friday or every other Friday. Friday's kind of play it by ear most because it's Friday. A lot of you guys want to go out and everything. So Fridays might be a little different. We will have a show this Friday, though, at 7 o'clock. And there I'm going to play voicemails. I left a number on the community tab on the YouTube page. Who the hell is calling me? Sorry, my phone just went off and said it was me calling me. How the hell did I call me? Okay, that was weird. It says I'm calling myself, and it did it again. I don't know. That is weird. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh, I put a number up on the column section. the community tab on YouTube. I put up on Facebook and Twitter. It's a number you call. It goes to a voicemail. You leave a voicemail there, and I will try to answer. Try to keep them around 20 to 30 seconds. I'm not going to pick out, maybe I'll pick one or two, and then next week, next Friday, I'll pick out another one or two. But who we got in the room today? We got Almighty, we got Vince, we got Brian, we got Gotti, we got SD13, we got James, we got Scary, we got Gotti, I read Gotti, we got Scary, I read that one, we got DC. We got a lot of people, and of course, we got Juan, says, when do I get my retro stuff? Well, that's the only news I really have, so I've had some people tell me that they have gotten their shipment of the Mandalorian retro figures. I haven't got any alert or anything that they're being shipped or anything yet. I don't know how they got them. I was trying to figure out where they ordered them from. It was really two different people where they ordered them from, but I wasn't able to find that out by the time we went live. So, if you pre-ordered the retro, and Cardoon is there, of course. Good to see that. But if you order the Metro, the Mandalorian retro figures, be looking soon. Your email that they're going to ship or something, be looking for them soon. And last night, I should have brought this picture up here. Let me see. Y'all don't mind, I'll throw up. I found some new Star Wars toys at Walmart last night, believe it or not. In fact, if you give me a second, if you don't mind me being unprofessional here, I'll send these over to my... I'll send these over because, you know, I don't keep up with the new stuff much, but I didn't remember these even... that these were coming out. Maybe I just missed them right there. So let me send them over and then I'll add them to the chat. And you guys can be... I did see the Black Series Jar Jar. Somebody says Jar Jar is the best character. I saw the Jar Jar Binks Black Series at Target today. $25.99. They had about five or six of them. They did not care about that. So is Candace here? Is Ashley here? Where are the girls? Are the girls here? Let's go through here and pull this up really quick, if you don't mind, guys. We're going to pull these up real quick. It won't take me just a second. Sorry, like I said, I didn't really prepare today. I had a lot going on. I had to drive 2 hours to do some things, and I didn't think I was going to get back in time. But actually, I did get back. So, let's pull these up really quick, and I will have these up for you. Uh-oh. Hold on. Let's do that while I get the... I need Larry. Where is Larry's off today? I was trying to get Larry to come in. Larry said, I'm not coming. I said, Larry, I need you to do my pictures for me. I ain't coming in there. Larry was having problems. I don't know. He says I demand too much of him. Okay, I think I'm going to have to size these down. These images are huge. And they're probably going to be turned wrong because I didn't have time to rotate them. So why are they so huge? Good Lord. Okay, but you can see right here, if you cover up my face, you don't mind that, do you? You got... Boba Fett on the Return of the Jedi card. Baby Yoda. Now, there's a couple more I found, but those are the two I wanted. And guess what? Didn't buy them. I went to Walmart. I picked them up, walked around with them, went to checkout. Self-checkout was all closed. Every register was closed but one, and they had like 20 people waiting in line. I said, I'm not standing in this dumb line. I couldn't believe it. So, you know what I did? I hit them. Yeah, you heard me right. I hit them. Maybe I should do a video of the best places to hide the toys. Because sometimes you walk in, you got to wait till Friday before you buy it. You got to wait till payday. I understand cash gets tight sometimes. You got to wait. Other times, maybe you just don't want to stand that line to check out. Maybe in a hurry. Maybe if it's more than three or four people in line, I'm not standing in it. If it's Burger King, it's McDonald's, I don't care where it is. I'm not standing in a line. So I hit them. Now, they had two of each. So I left some two for a collector, somebody else to buy them. But I left these so I could go back and get them. Hopefully, I'll go by tomorrow, swing by there and grab them. Because it's Boba Fett. Got to get Boba Fett. And I just love the Baby Yoda. It's so cute. So, we got that. And we had these right here. Pull these up so you can see them. Of course, got Boba Fett again. Got, of course, the Mandalorian figure. What's his name? I'm getting his name right now off the top of my head. The guy from Rocky. And then you got a Princess Leia. Not a very good picture. A little blurry. Can't really see the image. Odd picture choice they decided. I don't know why they decided that picture. And I really don't like the Mandalorian photo either they decided to use. I really didn't like that. And we got one more picture of this guy right here. The Zutton. The Snaggletooth type creature. So that's enough. But I found them at Walmart. So apparently they're hitting now. So if you're out looking for figures and everything, check those out. Those are starting to hit. Again, so we got Raw says screw that. I don't know what he's screwing. We got Left Coast Graphics says, they've already found them. Original Junkman says, Baby Groot is better than Baby Yoda. Get out of here. That's the stupidest thing I ever heard in my life. Baby Groot, adult Groot, teenage Groot. Groot is all stupid all around. Gotti goes bananas. I'm sorry, I bought one for $20. I don't know, maybe he bought the Jar Jar Binks. 20 is a little more reasonable, but getting the $26 plus tax, and get out of here. Those Jar Jars will be $10 soon, probably so. I don't know if they're shipping just to a case themselves. They have so many of them and nobody else. What's up, Junkman? Can we get some video about the 1985 droid figures? That will probably be, we'll probably do that one day on the Star Wars. I'll probably combine Star Wars, probably combine the Ewoks and droids together, talk about that on Star Wars Monday. That will probably be, we'll probably do that, just don't know when. Jar Jar is the best character in Star Wars, says Scary Butt. I don't know. Hey, Jar Jar, Rey Skywalker, pretty good. It's Junkman from the future. Answer it. Justin James got a lot in here. Now, like I said, I don't have my soundboard up. Soundboards are really hard to hear, and I think you guys like the video chats better. So let me know if you like the video chats better. And you should have got a chat alert box right here. I didn't see it come up. The guy sent me a super chat. Maybe it's because it was before I started the show. But today we're going to look at 80s commercial toys, and we're going to look at 70s. We're going to start with 70s and 80s. We'll start with 70s and then move on into where we kind of give you commentary on it. But I'm trying to see if there's anything else I need. Oh, yeah. Check this out, guys. Check this out. Whew. You see that? I see that. You see that? Boba Fett. Look, guys. Boba Fett. You see him? Look at that. Boba Fett right there. I saw that picture. I was like, oh my God, it's Boba Fett. Oh my God, I couldn't believe it. I was like, well, these damn girls move out of the way. I'm trying to look at Boba Fett. Look at Boba Fett. Oh my God, Boba Fett. Oh, I know it's hard to see, but somebody had an amazing costume of Boba Fett. Woo, that was a nice little costume right there. A Boba Fett now. We will be back tomorrow just to let you know. Pop culture in the morning. Pop culture. It's in your morning. We're going to have pop culture in the morning, 11 a.m. We got a super chat from Brian. Man, I feel good. I love super chats. Helps up the channel. Makes me do more of them. Really helps everything out. Some of you seem like the same people. Now I feel like, come on, every day. I feel like I'm taking too much money from you guys. But I'll pitch in on the fit. There you go. Thank you so much. Believe me, thanks for the pitch in for the Boba Fett. Now we can just get that line down. I don't know why. 10 o'clock at night, I know it's kind of late at Walmart, but they only have one register open. Self-checkout was closed. I mean, that's the whole point of self-checkout. But let's give Brian a video chat. I have a video chat for sending in a super chat. What do we want to give Brian? Let's see here. I should do these clips based on tiers or something. We'll give him, I know it's supposed to be random, but it's not. We're going to give him Charles Nelson Riley.
Charles, where does the joy come from? And I said, it comes from my blank and it blanks from my blank.
That's funny to me. I don't know if it's funny to everybody else, but I love that. Of course, that's Alec Baldwin as Charles Nelson Riley. I was trying to find a good Charles Nelson Riley clip and I couldn't find one. I think I do get it over there. So let's check out these chats a little bit, and then we'll watch some toy commercials from 1970 and then the 1980s. So let's see, here we got Bounty Hunter, Car Shop Reality is here. I didn't see that. All right, Car Shop's over here. Thanks, Solo. We got Raw Solo. Oh my. We got Ted is here. What do you think of the Black Series Return of the Jedi Boba Fett? I haven't seen it in person yet. The pictures all look good and everything from what I've seen of it, but I can't really say till I take a look at it. They've done a couple of them. Remember the one they did that had the Haunted Carbonite? That one I really wanted. Awesome. Thanks, Junkman. Said SD13. Trash Tritter says, howdy. Okay, like I said, I might miss some of these questions, but if you send a super chat, I'll be sure to see them. For Charles Nelson Riley clip, maybe check Match Game. Yeah, I checked some Match Game. Actually, I went through a lot of Match Game. I couldn't find anything that was like, found some funny stuff, but nothing that worked in a 3-5 second clip. But I'm sure there's some out there. Just dig around some more. I'll probably get rid of all the clips we got in a week and then change them all around anyway. Because you get tired of seeing the same things every time. So, are y'all ready? Hey, Junkman made it. Joe made it. Joe's finally here. We were all sitting here. We said, where is Joe? We got 60 people in. We're growing, guys. We're growing. First live stream, I think we were around 30 to 40 in the room. We were really excited. Monday, we got up over to 109 during the live stream. That's really, really good. We got 60 here. Not bad, especially being that we moved the time and I didn't promote it as much. So that's really good. I want to thank you all. That's very good. Will we see Alien Todd later on? Not today. I was hoping to work in some Larry the Wampa, some Alien Todd, maybe some other things, being it's the action figure show. But I talked about earlier, if you got here a little late, I was running behind today. I almost didn't even do the show. I had to go out of town 2 hours away. Got back about 6:30, and I was like, I can't make 7. I can't make 7. So I pushed it to 8, and then I was still pushing. Yeah, I won't get rid of this one.
This is like my show where I like talk to people who are pretty cool, and we'll like talk about things I think are pretty cool, and yeah, it's pretty cool.
Some I just have to keep. You know, I have to keep that one. And what's the other one I have to keep? Where's the other one? I can't find it right now. But some of them I have to keep around. And then some is just fun to play, like this one.
Okay, Junkman, I know you're still watching. Hear it from me to you. Fuck off, okay? You're not welcome here.
I'm not welcome here. Okay. You want to tell you what I watched last night? Believe it or not, I watched Tombstone. I've never seen Tombstone. I think I've seen parts and pieces of it, but I never really sat down and watched the whole thing. I'm going to send another picture to the computer, so that's why I'm doing it. I'm going to send this picture here to you guys so I can show y'all something real quick. I don't think I'm texting while I'm doing a show and being lazy. I'm just going to send a picture. Again, I didn't prepare much, and this one really wasn't planned. But I watched Tombstone. But it went on a little too long by the end. By the end, I was really ready for it to go off. But I really did enjoy it. Me and my son watched it, and we really did enjoy it. Val Kilmer's great in it as Doc Holliday. Everybody in it is great. And it seems like every scene, it was like, oh my God, that's blah, 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 from something else. I mean, it was, what an all-star cast, right? What an all-star cast. And today, when we were out of town, we just happened to be looking around. Well, my son actually Googled it and found this out, and I didn't even know. So let me see if I can pull this up really quick here. But I'm sure a lot of you have seen Tombstone. I'm really behind. You know, I'll be a huckleberry. I knew all the quotes from it and everything. But I don't think, like I said, I don't think I ever sit down and watched it, at least not since it's maybe when it first came out, maybe. Pull this up. Is this it? Well, it's upside down. Shit, how did I flip it? Sorry, guys. Why is it upside down? Well, shit, that's stupid. Why is it upside down? It's not upside down on my phone. Anyway, that's Doc Holliday's home. His dad's home, actually, where he was raised. I don't know why it's upside down. Sorry, it's upside down. Now, the original Doc Holliday. Apparently, he was born in South Georgia. And actually, he's buried something up about 40 miles north of me, so that'd be kind of cool. But anyway, I'm not sure all of you have seen Tombstone, so I'm a little behind. I've been to Tombstone, Arizona, walked through there and everything, seen where the fight of the OK Corral, but I really didn't remember the movie. Like I said, I might have seen it. Billy Bob Thornton has an uncredited cameo. I knew he was in that. I remember he was the poker player guy that was slapping everybody around, and he got bitch slapped himself. Didn't know it was uncredited. I don't know why it wasn't uncredited. I mean, he wasn't a huge star back then or anything. I guess he just came in to help out, but I didn't know he wasn't credited, but it was, I liked him in there. And what he said, it's like I'm playing cards with my brother's kids. I really liked his character. I thought he was going to turn up again later, but he never did. Junkman just made himself a laughingstock by crediting, "We got this covered." I thought it was funny. Whispered that he got a lot of subs. Who? Oh, Doomcock just made, I said Junkman. Doomcock just made himself laugh. Oh, God, is he getting his sources now from "We Got This Covered"? Even that his friend, Nerd Erotic, said he didn't believe his inside sources. So that should tell you something. But we're not here to bash on Doomcock. We're here to talk toys. Talk toys. Like I said, I don't have much toy news. I was going to do Figure of the Week and the Top 10 of some toy-related thing. But again, I was running behind. So we're just kind of winging it today. But I got some stuff we're going to do. Juan says you've been promising a Empire Strikes Back watch. Yes, I have been promising. I wish there was a way to do a watch along so y'all could watch it on the screen. I don't see why YouTube or whoever owns the copyright won't let us put up just a little window you know, size it down really small where you can't bootleg it. Watch it like that or something. Okay, I'm getting a lot of chats here. Sorry if I miss them, guys. Sorry if I miss them here. Again, super chats to make sure I don't miss them. But I'll try to catch some here and there while we're talking. But I will probably miss some. Let me do something else. Hold on, guys. Okay, sorry about that. Now, where was I? Okay, y'all ready to watch some 70s cartoons? Are y'all ready to watch some 70s cartoons? I know I am.
Huh? All right, fellas, and away we go.
So let's go right here. Like I said, I'm going to mute it because I don't want to risk being taken down. So I think we'll still have fun watching these. You know, yeah, I think we can still have fun watching these. Let me size it down a little bit, too. So I feel like I'm getting my head cut off. Okay, what we got first here? I don't know what this is. Very odd color. You know, didn't really hold this color well, whatever this is. It looks like some kind of girl toy, so I'll just talk over this. Girl toys. Who likes girl toys? I know today they say there's no such thing as girl toys and boy toys, but there is. What is, now there's a lot of 70s toys I won't remember, but these are pretty cool. I've never seen these. You know, I almost said pretty cool. These are pretty cool, actually. I don't know what those are, but it makes me want them, I tell you. I like those. I need that in my life. Some kind of little round car. It's like a little, yeah, it's got a little racer. Man, I might do a video on those. I've never seen those. Maybe you guys out there know about that. Never seen them. I like them, though. What is this here? Let me know if you think the picture's big enough. I don't want it too big. Kind of sports game. I don't remember this either. Like I said, a lot of these 70s shows. It's going to be more fun when we get into the 80s. I think we'll know more. But I thought it'd be kind of fun to pull up the 80s. Sometimes it's fun to check out some toys you haven't seen yet. Or you hadn't seen in a long time. So that's always good. I don't know if y'all hear that. I got a cat outside screaming. Sorry. What is this right here? Let me pull it up a little. Let me get it a little bigger so I can see it. Oh my god, I got a spinning wheel. I hope I don't just crash everything. Shit, maybe I shouldn't have touched it. Okay, I thought I had the spinning wheel there. Humpty Dumpties. I don't know Humpty Dumpties. Do you guys know Humpty Dumpty? Come over this way some. I don't know Humpty Dumpty. Oh, a cooties. Big game. I call it a game. It was called a game, and everybody saw it as a game. A lot of fun. A lot of fun. I just remember putting them together. Cooties. What is this? Is this that parking? Oh, I thought it was that parking lot. I don't know what this is. That looks fun, too. It looks like some kind of bridge. You put the cards on it. Whoever, you try to get the car across the bridge before they fall down? London Bridges. London Bridges falling down, falling down, falling down. It looks like Ashley is finally here. Ashley, welcome back. Ashley was wondering where you were earlier. We're asking for you there. That's some cool. They made some cool shit in the 70s, man. I've never seen this airplane thing before. I remember my brother had this game. It was like an airplane that you would look through the scope and you would try to drop bombs on this turning. It was like a turning turntable thing. I don't know what it was. You try to land it in. You try to drop these bombs on it. I have to look that up. I love that game. I remember one time I wanted to play it, but he wanted to watch Soupy Sales, and I was like, "Come on, go get it for me." I never seen this airplane game, but this looks really neat. It looks like it's on a string, but it looks like it's pretty damn high. You got to try to land it on the pad, I guess. Yeah, it's pretty neat. I like that. It's the longest toy commercial in the world, though. Longest toy commercial. Ashley sent in a super chat. I'll get to it when we're done with this video here. I hadn't figured out how... More cooties? I hadn't figured out how to pause videos. On Streamlab. Anyone know how to pause the videos, let me know. What is this? Some kind of little game here. Look how ugly these kids dress in the 70s. Yuck. Kids, get a style. Get a style. I get a drink on camera. Get a drink this time on camera. Okay, hush. That wasn't, that lady looked like she said it. What is this? Some kind of beans? Anybody remember a game called Cat's Eye? I used to love that game. Cat's Eye. You had the marbles and put all the marbles together until you get the blue one, the black one to put in the eye, and then you had to yell, Cat's Eye! I did a video talking about that one time. I couldn't find that commercial, and I was like, come on. I don't know this. It was a Don't Spill the Beans or something. See? I named that game. Didn't even see what it was called. Just, I saw what it was about, and I named it. So, what is this? Pickup sticks? Camel game? I was like, you got to put the sticks in the camel, and the first one knocks over the camel lose. Come on, man. Come on. It looks fun, but they just come up with anything. A lot of see if you don't, broke the camel's back on that one. Seemed like there was a lot of, do this before it falls stuff. What is this? A cheese grater? This is the way you get kids to work in the kitchen and help out while making them think they're helping out. Oh, no! Oh, this is one of those little scrapey ice things. Like the, what's his name? Snoopy. Thank you. Kind of like Iceberg. I don't know. Okay. That looks interesting there. What is this? It's all white. Play-Doh. Everybody knows what that is. Play-Doh. So it's got the girls playing. It must be the kitchen set here. She's got a little book telling her how to do it. Girls have to read, of course. That's what they're telling you in the 70s. They won't show the boys with a book, though, probably. Boys playing by themselves. I don't know what he's, I don't know what they're making. Damn, look at that car. Whoa, I couldn't have made no shit like that. That's plastic, right? Okay, that's plastic. I thought he made that whole car out of Play-Doh. Man, I was finna get impressed. Remember, the Play-Doh guy, Bill? Man. Oh, no. Portable. Now, I would have liked that as a kid right there. Oh, shit, I ain't lying. I want this now. Look at this. Oh, the girl lost. Oh, Stix's commercial. Oh. What an ugly little kid. Oh, you actually have to put money in it? Man, I want that now. I like that. That is what I need now. Awesome, man. Awesome. What else we got here? This guy's shaking his head. What's he upset he's about? Uh-oh. Kids and guns. What a good mix in the 70s here. Electric shooting gallery. Man, that's awesome. Man, that's some good toys. Look at that. Batteries are not included. Oh, no. Don't tell Rick Moranis. So you got to shoot the... Man, it looks like you shoot some really metal balls, too. You got to ring the... Man, that looks fun. I ain't gonna... Oh, you got... Man, it's got everything. It's got more than just one target. It even keeps score. A computer target, it says. Look at this. Man, this thing is awesome. You can take this thing to your local fair and charge people to play it. Oh, even Dad's getting into the act. Look at that. Even Dad let the girl watch. Oh, sexist 70s. Man, look at that. I like that. That's cool. What is this? Evil Knievel? No, it's on kind of a loop. It's not evil. It must be... just a daredevil. But it's on a loop and it spins around and does jump. Man, that is awesome. Why didn't we have that? Now we had Evil Knievel. Why didn't no one I know had that as a kid? I need to call my brother and ask him why he ain't had that shit. Look at that. Whoo. I bet half of that shit. No, I bet it falls over, but misses the ramp. And what is this right here? It's kind of like the Evil Knievel where you spin it up. And then it spins around, and that kid's a little too excited. Come on, kid. Ain't that exciting. This kid's a little overdramatic on this one. Those look pretty fun again, though. Anytime you get something that was made to smash in the walls and everything, it's always fun to go down the steps. Love sending stuff down the steps. Here's a choo-choo train commercial. Okay. First airplane. Cross over the bridge. Is this another get over the bridge before it falls again? That's trouble. This ain't cross the bridge. This is a trouble ripoff. Remember trouble with the bubble, and it'll shake the dice for you because they don't want nobody to roll a dice themselves. Look at these people. They're rolling around the ground having so much fun playing that fake trouble game. It's trouble again. This is I didn't watch this pre ahead, and this is actual Trouble. Is that what this is? Yeah, an actual Trouble. They had a Trouble ripoff, and now they're showing the actual Trouble game. They still make Trouble, right? I think I said Trouble about 55 times already. I cannot believe how many times I've said the word Trouble. Ooh, oh man. Ashley said, "Would I let a girl win? Depends on how cute she was." Okay, that's wrong. That's wrong. I shouldn't have said that. Go, 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 Motor Fig. Motor Fig, is that what it said? I don't know any of these toys hardly so far. I mean, no Trouble. I mean, who doesn't have Trouble? It's been around. Okay, these motorized vehicles, I guess. Probably something new, but, you know, it's probably new technology in the 70s, motorized vehicles. Batteries aren't included. I guess they're just wind-up. Go. From Ideal, the maker of the... you know, Evel Knievel. A baby doll commercial. I don't know much about baby dolls. Betsy Wetsy or something. That is creepy. It's moving its head by itself. Oh my God. Baby dolls are some creepy shit. I'm sorry. I'm going to go ahead and say it. Creepy shit. Man, that is some creepy shit right there, man. That is creepy. Ideal once again. Real Live Judy, is that what it said? Now, what's these kids doing? Man, they don't have much color in the 70s here. More wind-up cars, jumping, shooting over things. Oh. Oh. What did you? Yeah, I would let Amy Covey win. I'd be. That was Neil. Neil won. I wasn't even paying attention. Yeah, I would let Amy Covey win for sure. She would have won before she even got to the house. Now, what is this? I don't want to see. I'm gonna get in trouble showing a girl in the bathtub. Probably a kid in the bathtub. I'm gonna get in trouble for this one. Come on. Oh man, you girls love to practice like being a mom, don't you? I mean, we were out there jumping cars and motorcycles, shit we would never do, and y'all were there changing diapers and shit. Come on. Racetrack, man. What was better than having a damn racetrack? Oh, makes me want to go buy one today. They never worked as good as the commercials. I remember they had one in the 80s that said it went up the side of the wall. Never could get it to go up the wall. Look at that trigger, man. They would always come off the track, or they would spin out just a little bit where the metal didn't touch right, and they wouldn't go. Had to push them with your finger. Sometimes you took that track in the wrong thing. Remember you get my friend Justin, you could get him to lick the track, and you would hit that button, and it would shock the shit out of it. And he'd fall for it every time. He's like, "I'm not licking." I was like, "Well, promise I won't push the button and lick it." And he'd lick it, and we'd zap his tongue. What is this here? This is some girls being some mamas? Man, they really were trying to get these girls to learn how to be moms. I mean, you didn't see boy toys or how to change oil in the car. Man, them are some 70-looking girls right there. That is some 70s-looking shit. What is this? Top Secret. Let me know what that is. Top Secret. Val Kilmer in there? I'm going to see some new toys. What the hell is this? Barbie doll. Oh, that's creepy. Barbie doll, put a ring. Oh, you blackie, better put a ring on it. No, that's not a ring. What is that? Portable television? What was that? A boom box? Is the boom box Betty? Is that what this is? This is a fake Barbie, right? This ain't Barbie. This is too weird to be Barbie. A fake Ken. What is this? Come on, tell me the name of it. Or did I miss the name of it? Man, look at Four Eyes. Oh, it's pulled the string. Ha, get that Barbie. I bet you never had a pulled string. Bet you didn't talk, Barbie. That's better than old Barbie right there. Look, it even comes with dinner plates and stuff so you can serve your old man some food and keep him at home and happy. Ooh. Now look at her. She got some Daisy Dukes on. Who's that Barbie, fake Barbie with the Daisy Dukes on? Look at that one right there, man. Got some tight skirts. No peeking. No peeking. This is the longest commercial I've ever seen in my life. This is the longest doll commercial ever. Come on. I don't even know what to say about them anymore. Come on, girl. Next one, please. Raw Solo says he's cooking dinner tonight. Way to go, Raw. Cook that dinner. It's not a... Girls don't belong in the kitchen. Boys don't belong in the kitchen. Nobody... Everybody belongs everywhere. Ashley sent in a super chat. That's like two of them, Ashley. I got to catch up on, Ash. Thank you so much. I'll get to you in a minute. Don't be knocking Barbie, she says. I owe you two video clips. Don't be marking... Hey, I'm a fan of Kenner's Dusty Doll. Dusty. I still need to buy a Dusty Doll. I want to buy a Dusty Doll. What is... Okay, that... Is this the same damn commercial? Shit. This is crazy here. Ashley. I'll read Ashley's comment real quick, and then I'll give her two videos, I think, before I lose them. Man, you guys are sending a lot. I missed a lot. I'm sorry, guys. Again, super chats, make sure I see them. Maybe you can act out Empire for us, Junkie. Yeah, that might be good. Actually, really good. Act out Empire. Remember, I tried to stream Star Wars while I overdubbed everything, but they cut that shit off after 10 minutes. It's like, no, don't you do that. They were fucking more Barbie shit. This is turning into the action figure Barbie show or something. Come on. If I knew how to run it up, I would. Uh-oh, the girls are getting arrested for looking at Barbie dolls. How dare you, girls? Go back home. Only boys can look at this. A special prize for Skipper. Exclusive new Barbie action. New sewing surprise. I don't know, girls. I don't know if they're forcing all this stuff on you. How to be a mom. How to be a mother stuff on you. Or what the hell? I wasn't looking. I saw a rocket ship come flying in there and blew up the place. Did I just miss that? Did I just see a rocket ship come flying in there? Was that it? Was that the 70s commercials? That was the 70s commercials. And actually, I owe you two video clips. So I'm going to give Ashley. Can't play that one. I got demonetized for that one. So let's give Ashley. Give Ashley. We looked at the 70s, so this one is fitting. Ashley, this is just for you.
Song about Jelly Man Kelly. He loves jelly the most. Papa Moose of all. Jelly Man Kelly loves jelly on toast.
Everybody loves jelly, but not as much as Jelly Man Kelly. Jelly Man Kelly loves jelly the most, but most of all, he loves jelly on his toast. I think we can all agree with that, and we can all understand that.
Hey, Jumpman Channel popping
though. Jumpman Channel is popping though. Okay, Ashley, you've seen a two super chats, so we're going to give Ashley another one right here. Let's see what we can give Ashley here. I think I've done most of these. I mean, I'm trying to think of one maybe I hadn't done in the last video, but Ashley, what? Ashley, man, I'm running, I need some new clips here. Ashley, this one's for you.
And a smile that lights up the night, and it all belongs to Kid Dynamite!
That's right, Kid Dynamite. Speaking of the 70s toys, I had a JJ doll. I should have brought a picture of that up. I had a JJ pull the string doll, and I don't remember what it said, but I'm sure it said Dynamite. And speaking of dolls from the 70s, they made a Red Fox doll. Not a Fred Sanford doll. They made a Red Fox doll for kids, and you flipped it over, and it was Nightclub Fred too. Had two versions, had two faces, one on the front, one on the back. One was Nightclub Fred, and it was aimed for children, and it talked. And I think it said, "Who the hell sat on me?" or something like that. And I know I want it. I've never seen it, seen pictures of it, and I know I want it. Seen it a few times on eBay, and it's always way overpriced, or it doesn't talk. This is some creepy shit right here. Oh, so let's have, we're going to look at some 80s stuff in a second here. Some videos from the 80s. Hopefully we won't spend the last 10 minutes of that looking at Barbie. But let's just catch up. I can't catch. I saw a lot come up. I'm not going to be able to get to all of them. But again, if you want to make sure I see them, super chats. And it helps out the channel. It makes me do more live streams because it shows, hey, you guys really are enjoying it. And everything goes back into making this channel better. I know you're saying, how's it going to get better? It can't get better. But it can get better because we might find a way to do the sound clips better so you can hear stuff like this better. See, you couldn't even hear that. You're saying, Junkman, I don't even know what that said.
Hey, where are the white women at?
Maybe if I put my phone down here and play it through my phone, put it close to the mic, maybe. There's got to be a better way to do this. But we got a super chat right here from Walt Ross. Turn that shit down, man. Turn that shit. That shit was loud. Raw Solo did a super chat. Super chat. Did I say super chat? Things mean a lot to me.
Way to go, Raw Dog. Play Molly. He's asking. He wants to. He's requesting his own videos. Well, here you go. Just for you.
This is like my show where I like talk to people who are pretty cool and will like talk about things I think are pretty cool. And yeah, it's pretty cool.
That kind of sounds like me when I do my videos sometimes. I'll be honest, that does sound like. Now, let's look at this toy. It's pretty cool. I'll be honest with you. We just bought this toy. I just saw this at the store. It's pretty cool. Let's talk about it. Let's review it. It's pretty cool. That does kind of sound like me, be honest with you. pretend it's a baby doll. There you go. Wild Bill says, I want a galactic snacking car Doom. That'd be a good one. Oh, that reminds me of I had a video ready that I was going to do called 10 Reasons Why I Was Suspended Off Twitter. I was going to read some tweets, and that reminds me of one, but I never did do that. Hey, Miley. Hey, yeah, Miley SNL is pretty cool, Junkman. I'm happy to point it out weeks ago. Yeah, and I've always thought when I made videos and I say pretty cool, it always reminded myself of that. And I didn't think you guys thought that, but then you guys started saying it reminded me. I hate it now. Every time I say pretty cool, that's all I can think about. But, and then that girl that does Miley is great. I don't like a much stuff of the new Saturday Night Live. I guess that's still considered new era, but that she's pretty funny at doing that Miley Cyrus. And then seeing whoever does her dad, Billy Ray. Achy, breaky heart. You can tell my heart. Throw your hat on your toys behind. I don't do that when I leave, right? I am out of here. Take my hat off and throw them on the toys. But then I'll knock shit down. I don't want to do that. Hey, Jumpman, do you prefer the Moggle head Han Solo? I guess he means the pinhead Han Solo. I mean, the big head. Or the pinhead one. I think the pinhead one was better likeness of Harrison Ford. And the other one looks like he's been in helium. He does. I hate the big head one. And believe it or not, Kenner chose the big head one. They did the little head. Thought it was too small and did the big head. Kenner! What's wrong? That big, it looked like Beavis, or somebody said it looked like Ringo Starr, or one of the Beatles. I can see that also. But yeah, Vanessa Bayer. Yeah, she does the Miley Cyrus. Yeah, I always liked her on the new ones. I don't know if she's still on there. I hadn't watched Saturday Night Live in a long time. I always liked her. Yeah, she's pretty hot. She always had like little dots on her face, though. I couldn't ever figure that out. Dude, it's best that you learn, that you lean into it now. Just use it for one of your just use it now? Yeah. Yeah, I keep it in there. Usually now, but now I'm more self-aware of it, so I make fun of it. Like during the live stream, you know, I'll say it, and then I'll do this. Cool. I don't know if you heard about it. I'll do pretty cool. Let's see here. The small head Han looked the smallest. Who's that? Samantha. I didn't see Samantha Adams was in here. She's no related to Don Adams. I don't believe she's related to Don Adams. I could be wrong. Could be Don Adams' granddaughter. I could be wrong. Yeah, it doesn't look like George Harris, but yeah, the small head, Samantha says the small head looked better, and I will agree, it does look better. She's got horse teeth. Well, I guess it's better than her. I'd rather her have horse teeth than she have a horse cock, but that's just me. Big head Hansa looks like Aunt Jackie from Roseanne. Oh my God, come on. she's still hot, though. A little horse teeth. Never hurt anybody. Let's see here. Okay. Now, we're going to get back. We're going to watch some 80s stuff here. We're going to watch some 80s stuff. So, let's go into the 80s. We'll lead into the 80s with this right here.
I love it when a plan comes together.
Mr. Okay. T will return after these.
I was going to ask you if that was Casey Kasem. I wasn't sure. It sounded like Casey Kasem, but I wasn't sure. But, again, we're going to mute it just in case I don't get demonetized or the live stream doesn't get cut off. And I think we all know what this is. C-3PO cereal. I can't honestly remember buying these. I remember when they were out. I remember seeing them at the store and stuff. But I can't ever remember actually buying C-3PO cereal. Look at that big old monster thing. They ought to make that canon. A New Force at breakfast. Came out a little late. I heard Lucas had a little hard stench on doing anything with sugar, and that's why. Until later. What is this? Okay, it's some kind of man you tie to a... It's like a hang gliding action figure. I bet that thing... There is no way that damn thing works like that. I don't know. It's a little bigger than I thought it was. If that works... Why didn't Kenner or G.I. Joe... G.I. Joe should have done... Or there is G.I. Joe. I was going to say G.I. Joe should have done this. I don't know G.I. Joe, guys. So give me for that. That was G. I was like, G.I. Joe should make that, and it was. There's Mr. T's cartoon going off. What's this thing? Let's see if you mute it just for a second.
Next, tonight on Different Strokes, will Willis be voted prom queen? Then
will Willis be voted prom king? I can't wait to find out. I don't know. It was the 80s. They probably was like, we're not going to let one of those at our private school be a prom king. And there's a whole big racial issue, I'm sure. But let's see what we got here. We got McDonald coming to put some mail in the mailbox right there. Mac, is it just me? Or was Ronald McDonald Land very creepy? What a creepy guy. Creepy, creepy, creepy. He was always creepy to me. Retro Blasting has a snotty VO on those G.I. Joe hang gliders. I'm pretty sure he does. Was that Happy Meal? Do they do Happy Meals anymore? Or is that people didn't frown, parents frown on, well, not parents, people complain about it. They don't buy them, and then parents stop letting parents buy them. They still do Happy Meals? Or they call them something. They come with toys, probably come with damn apples or something. Now, what is this, Barney? Man, I remember this one. I can remember this one. Barney always trying to get those cereal from Fred. Fred, share your Cocoa Pebbles or your Honey Pebbles or Fruity, whatever they're called. Cocoa Pebbles. Man, I was about to buy some cereal that I hadn't bought cereals in years, and it was huge. Every box was huge. I was like, I don't want a box this big. I can remember that Frisbee. Oh, my God. I remember that Frisbee getting it in the box of cereal. Oh, my God. I would have forgot all about that if it wasn't for this commercial. Dude, Big Wheel, man. Big Wheel. The one I had was probably more of the 70s. This is the one with the emergency brake on it. Yeah, I had this one. The slider. Yeah, man, I remember this thing. This thing was awesome, man. I think the Green Machine might have had a brake on it, too, but I remember, I think I had this one here. Where you do that, try to slide, man. You think you one of the Duke boys, man. You think you Bo or Luke Duke come sliding around the corner by Tonka. Man, that is awesome. There's Hulk. Not Hulk Hogan. That's the Incredible Hulk. Oh, what's showing this? Come on, show me a toy. You know what that is. Ain't no need to even comment on that. That's Max Rebo Band right there. I need those microphones to complete my collection. Look at those cool happening kids right there. Lucky kids. Get to play with Jabba. Get to play with Cy Snoodles. And the Max Rebo Band. Has there ever been a... They get to play with Salacious Crumb. And they get the microphone. I don't even have the microphones. Oh, man. What a great commercial right there. What's next here? Fruit Roll-Ups. This isn't a toy. This isn't a toy. But who didn't love Fruit Roll-Ups in the end? They were never that good, but they were easy to get. They were something you could just get out your cabinet and eat pretty fast. They were on a piece of paper and you peeled them off. Oh, I bet they're horrible. I bet they are horrible today. Especially if they had one that was made in the 80s. Do they even still make Fruit Roll-Ups? That is something I haven't seen Fruit Roll-Ups. They can't still make them. I haven't seen those in years. Fruit Roll-Ups. Only kind of fruit I would eat. What is this? Cereal commercial? Oh, there's that frog that's always digging it. Dig it. He always wants you to clap hands and shit. Look at him trying to get somebody's cereal. The kids are trying to get that learn on in school, and he's over there trying to give them some cereal. Hey, that was she on Mama's Family? She was on something. I seen that lady on something, man. She went way too fast. What is it? This ain't toy commercials. Man, they really getting the kids to sugar. Get a cereal full of sugar and they get you free ice cream. Uh-oh, He-Man. This is one thing they brought back out, didn't they, for the retro line? I don't remember this. This must have been kind of later when I was... No, it was that original He-Man. Look at that kid's face. I think I do remember. I didn't like it. I didn't have it. I thought this was kind of dumb. Maybe that was just me. Look at this kid. That's probably the weirdest acting, especially when it's on mute. Look at playing my Skeletor. Oh, man. Come on, kid. Hulk. There's old Hulk. Somebody said the Mama's Family chick was... I was talking about that she lived next door to him, not the woman on there. Maybe he's thinking of the woman. I don't know if she was hot, but she had to be better than that teacher. What is this? A chocolate milk commercial? Fuck, I love some chocolate milk, man, especially as a kid. I love me some chocolate milk. What is this? Oh, God, man. Man, a really cold glass of chocolate milk. Hershey's. Oh, shit, I used to love that shit. Me and my grandma used to love it. Oh, my God, they still make that? I forgot. Oh, God, I used to love that Hershey's chocolate. It was so damn thick. Here's them damn elves living in the trees. And I know they still make that. I still buy them. Fucking Hershey's chocolate. I forgot all about Hershey's chocolate milk. Oh, my God. I bet they don't make that. Junkman, do another video about Hillbilly Dusty. I'm thinking about buying a Hillbilly Dusty off eBay and do something with it. I actually have a Dusty Instagram while I was going to do Instagram with it, but it was hard. I need to buy one and do something with Dusty. Dusty needs to be on the action figure show. White Trash Dusty. Bonkers. Remember this commercial? Remember this commercial really good. I used to love these commercials. Bonkers. Bonkers. It'll bonk you out. It sure would. Those were good, too. I don't think they made them anymore. I like Bonkers, man. Man, I want that Hershey's chocolate milk, man. I swear I ain't thought about that. My grandma used to buy it, and it would be at her house. And we would get a cold one right before we watch T.J. Hooker. Whew. What is this? Play-Doh. Was that French fry? Look at that nerd. He can't even push it down. Look. I don't like it. Look like a turd coming out of that. What, a frisbee? They like to get free frisbee. You don't play frisbee in the house. What's wrong with these kids? You don't stick a frisbee in your pocket in your living room. Oh, man, they're teaching bad habits. Man, at least the Flintstone kids took their frisbee outside. Ewok, Ewok, Ewok. Oh, man. Is that boy? That's not. What? They're going to scare the paper boy with their Ewok dolls? Got a damn boy playing with an Ewok doll. I wish he would have took that thing and ripped his head off. This is one stupid commercial. At least it is when it's on mute. Look at her. She's about to hug it on hers. I would have hugged on it, too. It does look pretty cute. I'll be honest with you. Oh, shit. Baby Yoda fell on the floor. Oh, well, no more Baby Yoda sounds. They always showing this bumper. More G.I. Joe. I don't know why I didn't get into G.I. Joe. Like I said, I was buying He-Man and Star Wars. Didn't have time for G.I. Joe. I had a lot of friends that really liked G.I. Joe. I had a G.I. Joe motorcycle. That was it right there, I think. Came with a figure. I don't know who it was or anything. I'm sure y'all do. Man. So I never really got into G.I. Joe. A lot of people ask me, do more G.I. Joe videos. I don't know. If I can't find an interesting story, because I don't know G.I. Joe's. So it's hard for me to do a video on him. Bubblegum Stolen. Oh, shit. Just remember the cowboy? I like the Bubblegum Cowboy. This must have been replaced by something else there. I don't know. I don't remember this one. This ain't toy commercials, though. There's a lot of other stuff. That damn guy! That damn guy was on everything. He was more in the 70s. He used to eat potato chips in commercials, too. He was a potato chip guy in the 70s. I swear, I'm not lying to you. I'm not making up shit just for content. I swear, he did. I don't know his name or anything, but I remember that guy. Maybe I'm thinking he did do bubble commercials. But I think I remember one of them chip commercials also. Now, what is this? Why are they showing me this? This isn't part of
it. You catch 30. Be there.
Be there. Stanley? Something. That is loud. That was good. Better mute that before Marvel tries to... Oh, my God. Y'all remember this?
Hi, I'm Byron Allen, and I'll be right back.
One to grow on. Holy fuck, man. Y'all remember that? One to grow on. I used to, that cartoon where they were morphing. Holy shit, man. I forgot about that. Man, one to grow on. What is this? No, I didn't play hockey till. Oh, yeah. Busted down the road. Busted down the wall. Oh, the mailbox sent us a super chat. I'll read it in a second and give you a video clip. A random video clip. Jumpman, do you watch Craftsman's? Oh, yeah, you eat doo-doo. I don't eat doo-doo. I eat doo-doo-doo. I don't know what Craftsman's is. What is this here?
That's not great.
Oh, they're showing one to grow on. Byron Allen is going to teach us what not to do when a bully or something comes up. Craftsman. I don't know what Craftsman's is. Do I eat doo-doo? No, but I drink Yoo-Hoo, which is kind of like liquid doo-doo. So, yes, I guess in a way I do eat doo-doo. y'all kill me sometime. He was on Real People. That guy was? I would love to hear this, but I'm scared they're going to cut the stream off if I unmute it. Look at that radio. Look at that hi-fi.
Oh, no. Somebody's busted my antenna.
Oh, no. Somebody's busted my antenna. Oh, that is a video clip. I've got to get that as a video clip. Oh, my God. And then that guy was like, oh, no. Somebody has busted my antenna. Oh, I love that. Oh, Junkman, did you ever eat the Rigi bar? Don't remember that one. Don't remember that one. Hey, Kool-Aid guy. Yeah, Yoo-Hoo. Chocolate flavor mop water. It is, I will admit, I don't know what's in that Yoo-Hoo. It's like liquid water, diarrhea or something, but it is damn good. Schoolhouse Rock? Yeah, Schoolhouse Rock. Just a chip off the block. I like that, man. Schoolhouse Rock was good. Is that Kenan Thompson? It did look like a little too young, maybe. Man, that was great, that ending, man. My antenna. Man, I got to get that clip. That kid, too, was like, oh, God, shit, dad's going to know with me. I broke his antenna. He knew he was going to get himself a butt whipping with the belt. That's how kids in the 80s got dealt with. Today, he was sitting down and discussed, why you don't break antennas? And the kid would say, dad, what the hell is an antenna? Antenna, however you say it. So we can pick up FM radio. And the kid would say, dad, what the hell is FM radio? And, okay. We got the Melvar. I hope I said that right. The Melvar is going to get a random video. Let's give him, y'all probably get tired of my Ziggy song here. What can we give him here? Here you go. The Melvar just for you.
You know what old Jack Burton always says at a time like this?
Who?
Jack Burton, me.
Ooh, Jack Burton. Whenever you're down, you're not sure, you just say, hey, what would Jack Burton do, right? Let's see if we can catch up on a few of these. I missed a lot of them. Again, Super Chats to make sure I see them. Hopefully, I didn't miss any of your Super Chats. If I did, let me know, but I don't think I did. I think I caught them all. He didn't need to cut him a switch. No, he didn't. Whip him with a section of a Hot Wheel track. Woo! I know a mom that used to do that to her kids. She popped him with that. Well, oh, God damn, but it hurt. All the memberries. Yeah, we just had a bunch of memberries, didn't we? Hey, Junkman, T&D Productions. Hey, how are you? No worries, Stephanie. I love that movie, Pork Chop Express. I don't know. That sounds familiar, but I don't know what that is. Joe says, who? Car Shop Reality said, Junkman, grab the clip of Remember It Like It Was Yesterday. Somebody else commented the other day about that clip, and I was like, didn't think anybody remember. I don't even remember what video that was. I had to dig around. I think it was my video when I looked back at later in that year when I was like, I remember that just like it was yesterday. I have to get that again. I didn't think, okay, U.S. Network Kid Club. You remember the U.S. Cartoon Express? Try to make that in a shirt, and I could never get it to come out good. Pork Chop Express from the truck from Big Trouble in Little China. Oh, Pork Chop Express. I did. Okay. I am losing my mind here. I should know that. Remember that 80s commercial about the Phillips, that woman trying to embarrass her husband in the restaurant? Yeah, I remember. Yeah, it's like I know just bringing it up. It's like your stomach ache. Michael Meneja, like Pepto Bismol or something. Yeah, I remember that. Where's the beef? I still don't know where the beef is, but you know that lady is still alive? I don't know. I'm just playing. I doubt she is. See if we missed any more here. We got only a few more minutes left of the action figure show, the lazy format. Oh, man, I love that kid. Got some Hershey's chocolate milk, junk man. Heck yeah, let's get some there. How about some Atari commercials? That might be fun. It's been fun. Let me know if y'all like looking at these commercials. Though they didn't kill the stream looking at them, so that might be fun to look at some more. Old video game commercials might be good. Let me show you. Tom read that one. Okay, I missed some of these again. Sorry if I missed them there. I think that was about it there. I think I got all the supers. And do you like the vintage Inspector Gadget show? I was a little too old when Inspector Gadget came out. I don't hate it. I didn't really watch it. Don't really have an opinion. It was okay from what I did see of it, but I never really got into it. I was a little old when it came out. They made a rap song about Where's the Beast? I'm sure they did. They made a rap song. Was anything in the 80s too more cringy than seeing adult white people rapping? Ugh, still cringy today, though. Claire passed away 20 years ago. Oh, where's the beef lady? Man, you know her name. Damn, T&D, you are a where's the beef. expert right there. Commercials are pretty cool. Commercials are, as they say, you know what commercials are. And you know what they say about the Junkman channel.
Hey, Junkman channel popping dough.
Yes, it is. It is popping dough. Sorry, just Darren Stevens has made it right at the last 1 minute. 1 hour. We're 1 hour in. That is it. That is the show. Junkman, can't you do a couple more hours? No. I could. Maybe we'll do it. Maybe as we start growing, we'll start doing a little longer show. But we peaked at almost. Last time I looked, I had 99 people in here, and we're down to 91. So we did. We did pretty well. Let's just see here. Catch up. Say goodbye to everybody. But be right. Let's do one more video just for the fun of it.
Once again, can you see my tears? Ziggy! Leap me far, far from here.
Marsha, Marsha, Marsha.
Marsha, Marsha, Marsha. And I think that's it, guys. I want to thank you all for coming tomorrow morning, 11 o'clock a.m., the Pop Culture in the Morning. Need to build that show up. We don't get as many people in the Pop Culture show, but that I understand it's 11 o'clock. But I wanted to do something for people that can't make the 7. Nobody really does live streams. We got Brian Ricklin sitting in a Pop Chat. It says Pop Culture in the Morning. That's right, Pop Culture in the Morning. Brian, we were almost done, but now I'm going to send a video your way for sending that in. So I want to thank you so much. It means a lot. Let's take a look at the very cute Natalie Portman.
I love being a princess. It's fun to dress up and wear the crown and all that, but what I really want to be is the elephant.
I don't blame. I always want to be the elephant also. But hey, that's just me. Somebody says, is that a Quantum Leap musical?
Ziggy, if you hear me, take me far, far from here. Let me leap to 89. That was a better year.
That is actually from Always Sunny, an episode where Scott Bakula plays himself. Very funny episode. I wish at the end he was showing him all blue and tingle in his episode. That would have been funny. But anyway, we're going to get out of here, guys. It's been an hour tomorrow, 11 o'clock. Pop Culture in the Morning. Don't know what the topic is. I will figure that out in the morning. We'll put it up and everything. And then around at 5 o'clock, the normal video of the day. And if you're a member of the Patreon or YouTube, you'll get that a little few hours early. And after show on Monday, you can do an after show with me. I might do an exclusive Patreon member, YouTube member live stream that's just for you guys too soon. It's so cool. Never saw that before. Yeah, check it out. Check out that episode. If you don't know if you watch Always Sunny, but check out that. Check out Phil Hartman in an Action Vision commercial. I will do that because I love Phil Hartman. He is the best, man. I love Phil Hartman. It might be fun to do Saturday Night Live. Do it maybe during one of these live streams. Talk about, you know, the best people of Saturday Night Live. This is too much fun, Junkman. I'll catch you later. Joe, I'm glad you're here. Jimmy's here. I got the white circle of doom and some scripts. Okay. JT says, how many licks? 7. 7. 1, 2, 6, 7. 7 licks to get to the center of a juicy pop right there. If you're looking for that, it's Sam Beckett episode of Always Sunny. It's when the gang turns black. I think that might be the name of it. It's one of the later season ones, so check that out. Phil Hartman played Captain Carl on Pee Wee Herman's Playhouse. Yeah, and he wrote helped write Pee Wee's Big Adventure. I think he's co-writer or helped with that. And I think he's in there, too, in one little scene, if I remember correctly, in a van down by the river. Chris Farley, man. Yeah, we got to do a Saturday Night Live. That's Pop Culture topic tomorrow, Saturday Night Live. You guys just helped me pick that. Tomorrow, 11 a.m., we're going to talk Saturday Night Live. So let's get out of here, guys. I will see you. My voice is giving out. I have a long day already, so we're going to get out of here. We will talk. We'll see you tomorrow at 7 o'clock, and then a normal video. But don't. 7 o'clock tomorrow, we'll be back for, what's tomorrow? Wednesday, Indiana Jones Talk. 7 o'clock tomorrow, live stream and Pop Culture tomorrow morning. Don't forget the live stream channel, That Junkman Live. Link's in the description below. Go there for the replays. Go there just to watch it, to build up my watch time. I've got to get the 40,000 watch times. And then we're going to put all the live streams over there. I want to thank you for watching. We'll be back very soon.